Hello, I'm David Tucker, and this is AWS This Week from a Cloud Guru. Now, I realize some of you may like warmer weather and hanging out on a beach, while others love relaxing by a fire with a warm beverage, but this is one of my favorite seasons of the year. You may ask, well, what season are you talking about? Well, it's officially pre-invent season. It's that joyous season where wonderful announcements start to trickle out before the biggest cloud event of the year, which is just a handful of weeks away. Yes, we do have to wait for AWS reInvent, which kicks off on November 28th, but we have some great announcements to tide you over until the conference starts. Without further ado, let's get to the news. One of the themes that I'm predicting for reInvent this year is that AWS will be releasing tools to help with managing workloads across multiple regions and multiple accounts. Now, for those leveraging complex multi-region workloads, management can be a bit of a pain, and AWS is trying to ease that pain. A new tool, the AWS Resource Explorer, lets you have one consolidated place to find what resources you have in an account, even if they're in a different region than the one you are currently using. Want to look up an EC2 instance across all regions by a specific tag? Yes, you can do that. Now, do you have an ID for a resource, but you don't know what region it's in? It can deal with that problem too. You can search across all regions by various different types of metadata, and you can even create a custom view of your resources. So you have a single place to go and see all resources that match the criteria you specify. Once you enable the service, you can even search directly in the search bar of the AWS console. Thankfully, you don't have to wait to get access to this tool. You can dive in today. Check out the link in the description for instructions on how to get started. Next, let's dive into SNS, one of the OG AWS services that's been with us now for over 12 years. Now, even though it's a pretty mature service, AWS has continued to teach it some new tricks. Just a few months ago, AWS announced a preview of a message data protection for the service. As of this week, this capability is now generally available. Now, let me explain this capability to you this way. Let's say you are passing around huge amounts of data, and you know that your application is handling personal information. You want to make sure that specific components of your distributed application aren't able to receive sensitive information like social security numbers or even credit card numbers. Well, you could certainly write a bunch of custom code to make this work, or instead, you could leverage this new capability from SNS and get automated detection of 25 different PII and PHI data identifiers. Now, while this isn't available in all regions, it is available in several, so dive in and check it out today. Do you remember that thing I said about AWS helping with the configuration and management of multi-account and multi-region workflows? Well, here's just one example. Placement groups are a capability within EC2 that enable you to launch instances in the same availability zone and yet have them have a low latency and high throughput connection with each other. Now, there are different types of groups depending on what your goals are for the group. Now, no matter which option you choose, those instances need to be under the same AWS account. At least that was the case until earlier this week. Now you can leverage the AWS Resource Access Manager to include instances from multiple accounts within a single placement group. Now, this is generally available, so you can try it out in any of the AWS commercial regions today. Finally, there is a new capability for users of Amazon's MemoryDB for Redis. Data tiering gives you the ability to leverage both the cluster memory as well as SSD drives. With this capability, you can scale your overall amount of storage to hundreds of terabytes. That's almost enough to store a list of all the poorly named AWS services. Now, this capability will take care of the heavy lifting of moving the more frequently accessed data to the in-memory store while storing the other data on the SSD drives. Check out the link in the description to get started. Listen, pre-invent is just getting started, with re-invent just around the corner. You'll want to stay tuned this month to catch all of the new announcements. Thankfully, you already know where to find the latest AWS news, right? It'll be right back here on AWS This Week. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.